I'm Jeremy Shechter. I'm the aquaponics manager here at FarmTech in Dyersville, Iowa, and you're here with another edition of Stems and Scales. Today we're going to talk about choosing your fish in your aquaponics system. So the first and maybe one of the most important questions you're going to have is, what kind of fish do I use for my aquaponics system? So here at FarmTech, we actually raise Nile tilapia for a plethora of reasons. They grow extremely fast. They can tolerate poor water conditions, so all the dirty water and stuff that other species can't tolerate, the tilapia can. They've been cultured for almost 4,000 years, way back to the Egyptians. The great thing about tilapia is that they have a food conversion ratio of just about 1. So that means for every pound of food that you feed them, they'll give you a pound of growth back. And I don't know any other livestock animal that can come anywhere close to that, even other fish. One of the most common aquaculture species are salmon, but as we know, salmon are carnivorous, so they need a lot of protein and a lot of food to put on weight. Tilapia don't need any of that. They're omnivorous, so they can eat vegetables and things like that, so they need a much lower protein content. Tilapia aren't the only fish you can choose. There's a lot of other fish, and it's going to depend on personal preference, your climate, and of course the market around you. You can grow fish for food, or you can grow fish for pond stocking, or you can even grow bait fish. So a lot of people will grow native species like yellow perch or largemouth bass or even bluegill. And what they do, they sell them to people who own ponds to stock them for decorative or recreational uses. But again, these fish aren't going to have the great food conversion ratio or quick growth that tilapia have. Tilapia will reach plate size in about 9 months. And plate size for tilapia is about 12 inches and a pound and a half. Now, 9 months is very quick for fish growth. It's quicker than catfish, it's quicker than trout, it's quicker than salmon. Something that all these fish that I've mentioned have in common are that they're freshwater species. Whether it's yellow perch, you can raise salmon in freshwater, trout, tilapia, all freshwater. You can't raise saltwater fish because the plants that we grow here aren't accustomed to the high salt content, so they would do very poorly. So some examples of fish that you can raise would be yellow perch, salmon like I talked about, trout is really popular, catfish, bluegill, things like that. Anything that you could grow in a recirculating aquaculture system, you can grow in aquaponics as long as you keep the water quality parameters in check. So for example, something like a trout or a perch is going to need much, much clearer and colder waters with higher dissolved oxygen than the tilapia are. The tilapia, like I said, are from Africa. They basically grow up in a mud puddle that they don't know when it's going to dry up. So they can tolerate low dissolved oxygen, high turbidity, things like that. Now that you've picked the kind of fish that you're going to raise, you want to make sure that you get it from a reputable dealer. So you want to make sure that your fish are disease-free and hopefully are one gender. So all the tilapia that we raise here, they come to us as male. If you think about it, you want all the guys swimming around the water tank. They don't have to worry about females, so they can eat as much as they want and get as fat as they can, and they grow very quickly. Now that you know how to choose your fish, you can get growing. Try growing aquaponically. It's like fishing in a bucket.